still kind of feel like I'm in the days. I really don't know what to say. It's like, I'm living in a dream. It's kind of hard to explain, honestly.
I know it's just, I mean, people may say, okay, it's just a vocal plainly, but for you guys, this is all about getting better. What does this kind of performance mean for you going forward?
It boosts a lot of confidence. I'm coming back from surgery. I'm just a little over 12 months right out of the surgery. So it boosts my confidence a lot. That was what I came into this summer trying to do. It boosts a lot of confidence and learn command on my pitches.
What type of surgery did you have in your elbow? Oh, wow. Did you pitch this last season for Georgia?
No.
This is your first action, and all of a sudden you go a no-hitter. Wow. Did you anticipate that you had that type of stuff coming in tonight, or are you still trying to work your way back?
I'm just still trying to work my way back. I mean, I've been feeling good. I've been fortunate enough to come back pretty strong, and I'm going to keep building off of this.
What was it like in the dugout? I mean, were teammates talking to you, leaving you alone?
Honestly, it was like the sixth or seventh inning when I realized that I had a no-hitter because nobody was coming close to me. And the dugout was quiet when it's normally loud, everybody joking around, goofing around, and trying to figure out what was going on. And I just glanced up at the scoreboard and I saw a bunch of zeros, and the heart kind of sank a little bit because I knew it was a little high on them. So
this was your first game since the time?
No, this is my fifth start.
Okay, when did you have the surgery? What day did you have the surgery?
June 5th.
Okay, all right.
Did you ever throw a no-hitter in high school, perfect games going up, anything like this?
I threw a no-hitter like when I was a lot younger, you know, okay. 12, 13 years old. So.
Been a while.
This is the first one.
Just how relieved were you with it? Madison got that hit to give you at least a 1-0 lead.
I knew our guys, we're really coming off strong hitting-wise. Like, our offense coming off strong, and I didn't have a doubt in them. But Madison, he's a great ball player, and I knew he was going to come through. He had actually told me the inning before. When I went out for that inning, he said, hey, keep pitching good, get us back in the dugout, we'll get you one next inning. Sure enough, he came through in the clutch, and he got us one.
Was there any doubt that you were going to finish this thing off? I mean, you looked a little tired towards the end. I can imagine why, with this being only your fifth start since Tommy John surgery. I mean, was there any debate about whether or not you were going to finish this thing?
Well, I came in from the seventh, and Coach told me what my pitch count was at, and I said I got one more, and Trevor Hutto said, no, you got two more. And I'm working with a pitch count. I stay pretty close to it, like saying, you know, I'm not supposed to go over this number of pitches. But as long as I kept going well and I didn't feel too exhausted, I was going to keep going.
What did Coach Johnson tell you in the eighth inning before you got the double play?
He was talking to the umpire. He told me to keep filling it up, keep throwing strikes, and just ask the umpire, you know, where that ball was, and they talked about the ball strike, whether it was or it was not a ball strike.
Where will this night rank in your personal memory history bank?
Probably number one. It's got to be. You know, this is a great feeling.
Awesome. Congratulations.